From the RSNA, I'm Dr. Linda Chu, and welcome to the Radiology Journal podcast. Our topic today is the performance of radiologists and radiographers in double reading mammograms, and Dr. Francis Deng will lead our discussion.
This is Dr. Francis Deng from Johns Hopkins University and co-host of Podcast for Radiology. It's my pleasure today to speak with Drs. Ian Chen and Jonathan James, the first and second authors of the original research article entitled Performance of Radiologists and Radiographers in Double Reading Mammograms, the UK National Health Service Breast Screening Program. Dr. Chen is Associate Professor of Cancer Screening at University of Nottingham. Dr. James is Consultant Radiologist at Nottingham University Hospital and Director of Education and Training at the Nottingham Breast Institute. Welcome to the podcast.
Hi.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for joining us today. I'd like to start off with a little bit of background. So what is the standard of care process for screening mammography in the United Kingdom?
Well, in the UK, we double read all our screening mammograms. Traditionally, that was two radiologists. But in the sort of late 1990s, we ran into workforce issues. So we began to use radiographers as one of the readers. But two humans look at the mammograms, because we know it gives us the best cancer detection rate. It increases our cancer detection rate between about 6 and 15%, but also really importantly, it keeps recall rates low. So double reading is the standard of care of all screening mammograms in the UK.
Now, having trained in the United States, I'm more familiar with the model of using computer-aided detection. Is that part of the process in the UK?
No, computer-aided detection has never been part of reading in the UK. I mean, we did investigate it back in 2008, actually. We did a large trial comparing a single human reader using an AI system to human double reading. And we published that in the New England Journal of Medicine back in 2008. And basically, it showed that the cancer detection rate was the same between a single human reader using a CAD system and double reading. But unfortunately, it led to a significant increase in the recall rate. So it actually made single reading with CAD not cost effective in the UK screening program.
In the process for double reading, is the second reader aware of the first reader's impression, and how are discrepancies reconciled?
It depends slightly on the hospital setting where you're reading. Most people, the second reader is blinded to the first reader as they're reading. They're not completely blinded, because after the reading episode, they could potentially go and look what the first reader had actually said. But generally, they are blinded to some extent. Yes, we will have a certain number of cases, usually around 2%, where the two human readers disagree. We do have either a consensus or arbitration process for that. And it depends really on where you work. In my own particular hospital, we actually use an independent third reader. So if there's disagreement with the first two readers, then a third reader looks at the case independently and makes a decision with access to the first and second reader opinions. Some hospitals will sit down and have a consensus panel discussion where they actually come to an agreement either amongst the two readers themselves about the recall decision, or will involve other readers in a panel process. So it varies from place to place.
It seems that the double reading process can be quite labor intensive. So what is the role of non-radiologists in this process in the UK?
Well, you're quite right, actually. It is labor intensive, which was why we began using radiographer readers back in the late 1990s when we started to double read in the UK screening program. We initially did some pilot studies at that time and found that it would be possible, if radiographers were suitably trained, to read mammograms effectively as a reader. And so it became sort of established practice. So really, over the last 20 years, it's become standard of care for a radiographer to be at least one of the readers. And in some hospitals, actually, radiographers sometimes will do both reads if they are particularly short of radiologists. But the standard tends to be one radiologist and one radiographer in the double reading workflow.
Can I just add, those radiographers are trained specifically in diagnosis and the management of breast disease, and then they would take on an accredited module at a master level for a minimum of 12 months.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's quite intensive. It's quite an intensive training program. These are not just, they start life as radiographers who perform mammography, but then they are specifically trained up to read. And it's probably actually the reading training you get is more intensive, really, than our residents would get in the radiology residency program, because the radiographers who read will get a year of screening, as Dr. Chen says, get a year of training, which involves sort of a combination of lectures, sitting with consultant radiologists, and there's various test sets that they do along the way as well. And they have to be signed off by a mentor in their own hospital. And they have to have the same, they have to read 5,000 screening mammograms in their training year. So it's really very intensive training. So I have confidence that the training that we give our radiographers is actually very good.
That's very interesting. Is there any prior literature on the performance of these radiographers?
Yeah, when we first started doing radiographer double reading in the late 1990s, it was introduced initially as part of a clinical trial, several clinical trials. And they did show that the cancer detection rate between the radiographers and the radiologists was the same, but there was a tendency for the radiographer readers to overcall. They tend to have higher recall rates. But of course, these studies now are over 20 years old. They were performed in a pre digital era, so they were done on screen film mammography. And of course, now the use of radiographer readers become embedded in the screening program, become standard of care. So we thought it was really time now to relook at it again and actually look at our performance of our readers in this sort of digital age. And also the groundbreaking thing was we've now got really robust performance data for all our readers, both radiographers and radiologists. And so Dr. Chen was able to get permission to access that performance data, which was really important in actually being able to do this study.
Great. Can you summarize for us what the purpose of your current study was?
The purpose of our study was just simply to compare the real-life performance of those radiologists and radiographer readers in the double reading environment in the UK breast screening program, obviously considering different levels of reading experience.
How large was your sample?
We have in total 401 readers, 224 are radiologists and 177 are radiographers.
Were these data collected centrally in the UK breast screening program?
So all readers who took part in what we call individual performance assessment scheme called PERFORMS is a mandated activity in the UK. So whoever has taken part in that scheme is eligible to take part. Then they were asked to give consent for their individual breast screening performance data to be accessed from a system in the UK called Breast Screening Information System for the 3-year period, so 2013 to 2016. As part of the evaluation scheme. For our study, the individual National Health Service breast screening readers, cancer detection rate, recall rate, and positive predictive value available from the breast screening information system for the most recent 12 months in the 3-year period was used.
That sounds like a wealth of information. What were your major findings?
Well, no difference.
Yeah, basically, there was no difference in the performance of the radiographer readers and the radiologists. Cancer detection rate was the same. We did find that all readers, whether they were radiologists or radiographers, actually reduced their recall rate with increasing reader experience. So more experienced readers, whether radiographers or radiologists, had reduced recall rates, which led to a higher positive predictive value of recall for more experienced readers. But for a given level of experience, so those we say with more than 10 years experience who are radiologists and radiographers had exactly the same cancer detection rate, exactly the same recall rate and positive predictive value of recall. So there's no difference between the two given the same level of reader experience. And that's probably one of the things about the previous studies that have been done is that nobody took any account of reader experience. And you tend to find, of course, that radiologists tend to be overrepresented in the groups with most experience. Training radiographers up is a relatively new thing. So the radiologists tend to be the most experienced readers in a particular hospital.
Given that this program is now more well established, are radiologists still overrepresented in the more experienced group?
They were actually, yes. In our those with more than 10 years experience.
I'm seeing in the group of more than 10 years experience, there were 131 radiologists and 78 radiographers.
Yeah. So there were more experienced readers in the group with more than 10 years experience. But as I say, for a given level of experience, the most important thing that there was no difference in the performance between radiographer and radiologist readers.
So these findings are very interesting and also reassuring to the people following your program.
It's been actually really gratifying to show that there's no difference in the performance of readers from either professional groups. when we look at the key breast screening performance metrics?
I think absolutely. I think that's very important. It really gives us really good evidence of what we're actually doing in the UK breast screening program really works. So it has become established practice now. And I think we thought also it was really time that we told the world about what we were doing, really, you know, because it is now part of standard of care in the UK. And we're not the only country in the world that's experiencing staff shortages, be it radiologists or radiographers. So we thought it was about time to perhaps publicise our own reading experiences to the rest of the world, where perhaps hopefully others might be interested in adopting similar approaches to reader shortages.
Mm-hmm. So what are the limitations to your conclusions?
I start with the easy one, shall I?
Okay.
The study only provide evidence to support the participation of non-radiologists as readers in the program that employed double reading.
Yeah, I mean, this has been done in a sort of screening program where double reading is standard of care. So we've got to be slightly careful to extrapolate into a program that perhaps just used single reading. Mm-hmm. But I say I do have confidence that our readers would perform just as well in single reading, because what we've looked at in this study is the performance of people when they act as first readers. Mm-hmm. So that initial read, which is completely uninfluenced by any other read. So we've compared the performance of the radiologists and radiographers as first readers. Mm-hmm. So I have confidence that they will perform just as well as single readers, but we have to just be slightly careful that we don't extrapolate this into single reading programs. Have to use that bit of caution there. The other thing, I think the other limitation is that, of course, we did have some readers who didn't consent to have their real life data accessed. Yeah. And 124 readers weren't keen for us to act or didn't give us consent to access their real life performance data. So you have to start to think, well, why is that? But anyway, that is a slight limitation as well, that we couldn't get permission from all our readers to access their real life data.
Are there any take home points you would like our listeners to know?
I think probably the main take-home point I would say, first of all, is that radiologists and appropriately trained radiographers acting in these sort of physician extender roles perform equally well reading screening mammograms. They have the same cancer detection rate, the same recall rate, and so the same positive predictive value of recall. The ability to read a screening mammogram really has far more to do with appropriate training and experience than really simply having a fancy medical degree. It's far more about having sort of good training and good experience makes you a good reader of screening mammograms.
Dr. Chen and Dr. James, thank you so much for sharing your insights with us today. Our listeners can find their article in Radiology Online now, accompanied by an editorial from Regina Hooley and Melissa Durand entitled Equalizing the Performance of Radiologists and Physician Extenders in Screening Mammography. Thanks for listening.
Thank you, Dr. Chen and Dr. James, for sharing your experience in double reading screening mammograms that showed equivalent performance between radiologists and trained radiographers. As we deal with increasing volumes and shortage of radiologists, physician extenders may be part of the solution. But we must emphasize high level of training for these physician extenders and have rigorous quality assurance programs in place to ensure that we're providing quality care for our patients. This wraps up this week's podcast. Thank you for tuning in and supporting our podcast program. Please subscribe today on Apple Podcasts, Google Play, or Spotify. Come back next week for a new episode. Take care.